All right, we're going to make potato fans. They call by all sorts of names. They're all over the internet. They're pretty cool. We've done these a couple of times. We liked them, so we're going to show you how we do them. So first things, I got some butter that I melted, and I mixed half and half with some olive oil. And we're going to use that to brush on the potatoes. I've got some kosher salt to put on the potatoes. And then I've got some russet potatoes, okay? You could use different kinds of potatoes, but baking potatoes tend to work a little better. Russets, in our experience, work the best. First thing you want to do is cut a nice little sliver off so that it will sit up, okay? We're just going to take a knife, a sharp knife, and we're going to cut almost down to the bottom. And in order to make sure we don't cut all the way through, let's just lay us the wooden spoon or something there, and we just cut down to it. Bam, bam. As thin as you can get, the better your results are going to be. Okay?
Who are
you? Okay. So the next thing you do is you just take your butter oil mixture and you just douse your stuff pretty liberally.
Yeah.
Yeah. You like that?
Put on that one.
Put it on that one?
Yeah.
What are we making?
We're making that.
Making that? What is that?
It's a
steak. Is it a potato?
It's a potato.
You like a tater?
Yeah.
You like a potato?
It
is hot. It's very hot.
Yeah, that's going to burn the fire.
We gonna burn the house down with fire? Hopefully not, Boogie.
I'm gonna hold you.
You wanna hold me?
Yeah.
The butter's hot. It's okay. So we just douse it liberally. Then we're gonna bake it at 475 for 30 minutes. Take it out, and then I'll show you what we do next. 375 will make this thing smoke pretty terrible. But if you see, they've sort of opened up a little bit. They thinned out. And the thinner you cook them or cut them, the more you're going to see that. And now we're just going to spread more oil butter in there to get it to soak in so that it crisp up. And my slices, because I don't like anything going to waste. And you can put all of it on there now. And at this point, you can sprinkle on some salt, some pepper. I've seen people put, you know, crust on there, Parmesan cheese. I've done it with I've used sliced or shredded up cheese on here before. Trying to think of what kind. I think it was Monterey Jack, but cheddar's usually my go-to. Sprinkle a little bit of salt on there, and then they just go right back in the oven for another 30 minutes. Here's the finished product coming out of the oven. All told, we baked it at 425 for an hour. 30 minutes, pulled it out, dusted it back with oil, cut it, you know, baked it another 30 minutes, took it out, about 10 minutes toward the end, dusted it over with oil again and put some cheese on there. But you don't have to do that. But there you go. Until next time, you catch us online, www.tngun.com.